So what exactly is a high altitude balloon anyways? That's what we're talking about on today's video. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. Many people don't realize the history behind high altitude balloons and how they relate to today's society. So let's start with what they are. A high altitude balloon is a balloon that's filled with helium, hydrogen, or rarely methane, that's released into the stratosphere to an altitude of around 65,000 to 120,000 feet. This is commonly referred to as near space, which is an area of the Earth's atmosphere between the Armstrong limit and the Kármán line. This part of the atmosphere is high enough where no human can survive without a pressurized suit or cabin, but low enough where there's still a little bit of atmosphere that can cause drag on satellites or still provide aerodynamic lift on an airplane if it travels fast enough. Typically, high altitude balloons carry a payload which contain electronic equipment such as radio transmitters, cameras, and GPS receivers, but they don't have to. The first known public experiment with a hydrogen balloon was performed in 1783 by French professor of physics Jacques Charles. Charles spent 5 days filling his balloon in front of a crowd of over 300,000 people, including Benjamin Franklin. His balloon flew 12 miles from his launch site in Paris for a flight that lasted about 45 minutes. Obviously, no electronics were on board for this flight, but Charles was testing the idea of using hydrogen as a suitable lifting agent that would pave the way for modern day balloon flights. It wasn't until about a century later when French meteorologist Léon Tisserand de Beauce started launching hundreds of instrumented weather balloons meant to study the atmosphere. Léon was a pioneer in instrumented balloon flights and is credited with discovering and naming both the troposphere and the stratosphere. Today, balloons are used for a number of different purposes, including measuring weather and atmospheric conditions, planetary research, engineering education, photography, videography, pollution monitoring, and some are just for fun. The U.S. National Weather Service alone launches 70,000 weather balloons each year, generally 2 to 3 times a day from airports and weather stations across the country. This method of reaching the stratosphere is so cost-effective that some people call high-altitude ballooning the poor man's space program. Each different balloon purpose uses a unique payload package based on its objectives. Most commonly used payload in the U.S. is the classic radiosonde launched by the U.S. National Weather Service, which can measure altitude, pressure, temperature, humidity, wind, and positioning. This instrumentation is pretty similar to our balloon flights. Some specialized payloads have different names too, like the ozonesonde or the ozonosonde, which measures ozone concentration, a rawinsonde, which measures wind speed and direction, transisons, balloon sats, or super pressure balloons, which are designed to stay aloft for long durations. There are also pilot balloons or ceiling balloons, which measure the height of the clouds. Just recently, high altitude balloon photography has become increasingly popular to obtain some amazing photos and videos from these higher altitudes. With the exception of those meant to stay aloft, most high altitude balloons are designed to travel to a certain altitude, burst, and then parachute safely back to the ground. We recover, or at least we try to recover, all our payloads, since that's how we obtain our photos and videos from the flights. However, the National Weather Service doesn't typically even try to recover their payloads. They receive all their data from the radio transmissions, so you could potentially find one of these payloads during a walk through the woods or a walk on the beach. Just like our payloads, they usually contain an information label on the outside of the package, which contains instructions on how to dispose of the payload or return the payload to the National Weather Service if they want it back. In addition to the National Weather Service, high altitude balloons are also used for research purposes by space agencies like NASA or ESA, and even government or military organizations use them. These research balloons have been used for measuring atmospheric conditions and planetary conditions, or even carrying onboard telescopes like this 1957 Skyhook balloon. Private companies are also embracing high altitude balloons. Google's Project Loon is working to expand internet access with 4G LTE speeds to remote areas of the world using high-altitude balloons. Even Red Bull famously sponsored the Red Bull Stratos project, where Austrian skydiver Felix Baumgartner broke the speed of sound with nothing but his body after jumping from an altitude of nearly 128,000 feet. So what do you guys think of high-altitude balloons? Are there any cool experiments or ideas you have for the use of high-altitude balloons? What else do you want to know about the process? Let us know in the comments section down below. As always, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it and you like what we do, hit that thumbs up button. If you want to learn more about anything we covered today, check out the links in the description below. And be sure to subscribe to our channel so you never miss a video. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for updates on our project and to see our live launch day broadcast so you never miss one of our flights. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.